Let's discuss some incremental analysis concepts and terminology. Now I'm going to give you some definitions to write down, but I also want to give you an example of each one as we go along. Incremental analysis. Now write this down. Decisions involve a choice among alternative courses of action. Incremental analysis is the process used to identify the financial data that change under alternative courses of action. Now that's a mouthful, but I want to focus you in on the financial data part of this and how it might change under alternative courses of action. For example, let's say that you had to make a business decision. One was to make a left turn, and if you make a left turn, that would cost you $100. And the other alternative course of action would be to make a right turn. And if you made the right turn, that might cost you $200. So incremental analysis is this process used to identify this financial data, being if you go in one direction, it'll cost you $1 amount. And if you go in a different direction, it's going to cost you a different dollar amount. You're going to use that financial data in order to help you make a decision. And so this is what we call incremental analysis. Relevant costs. Relevant costs are costs that differ or change among alternative courses of action. In incremental analysis, pay close attention to these costs. If I go back to my earlier example of you running a business and you've come to two different courses of action you can take, one is turning to the left, that might cost you $100, and turning to the right, the alternative course of action, would cost you $200. So these are relevant costs because they differ among the alternative courses. Now, if turning to the left cost you $100 and turning to the right cost you $100, well, that wouldn't be relevant in your decision making, because those choices did not differ based on the financial data. Opportunity costs. One cannot take two or more courses of action at the same time. An opportunity cost is the potential benefit lost by taking a specific action over another. And opportunity costs are always relevant. They are always relevant. Let me give you an example. Let's say that you have the option of taking a full-time job that pays you, I don't know, $40 an hour. And the alternative is you going to school to continue your studies as a student. Well, when you evaluate the cost of being a student, let's say that in this scenario, you can't both be a student and take the full-time job. I would tell you that the cost of you being a student should also include that $40 an hour that you're not able to do because you've chosen to become a student. So the opportunity cost there is that $40 an hour that you'd be losing out on. Sunk costs. A sunk cost is a cost that has already occurred in the past and cannot be changed or avoided. And this type of a cost is not relevant to decision making. It's just not relevant because it's already occurred and you can't change it, you can't avoid it. A good example of this is, let's say that you bought a computer 2 years ago. And let's say that computer cost you $800. Well, is the cost of that computer relevant to you making a decision on whether or not you should buy another computer? And this might be a little difficult to wrap your arms around, but I would say that because you paid the $800 in the past, you can't change it. So I would tell you that that is a sunk cost. and you should base your decision on whether or not to buy a new computer on other factors other than how much you paid for your old computer. For example, you may want to begin to focus on, well, how much does a new computer cost? That would be relevant. But the cost of the old computer is not relevant. It's in the past.